All right, everybody, welcome back to Kremin Incorporated. I'm gonna give you my review of the Citizen's K16 Type E. As I mentioned in my last review of our Citizen's L32, we have five different models of Swiss style lathes in our facility. If you haven't seen the L32 review, you're gonna wanna click the link below and check it out. I have no idea what the K means in the Citizen's lexicon. I know we have A's, we have L's, and now we have a K. But I do know that what the 16 means, and that's the max diameter material in metric that the machine is designed to handle. So 16 millimeters is 25 point something millimeters in an inch. 16 is about half. I'm not the best at math. About 0.5, 0.6 inch diameter material is what this machine will take. So I know what you're thinking. Mike, your L32s, your A20s, your A32s, they can all run material that's this small. Why would you have a machine to run just 16 millimeters or less? Speed. We want parts running on this machine that are 20 seconds or less, so we want a much smaller work window to give us the most optimized cycle time when we're quoting small parts. So if we look inside the K16, the first thing you notice if you compare it to our L32 video is it's much more compact. This machine is designed a little bit differently with the turning tools kicked on an angle. We have four live tools on the arm that can turn, mill, and drill. We have one live tool for the subspindle on the bottom, and we have four static holders next to the sub at the pickoff. Much closer space, much more compact, much less time moving between tools and moving between sub and main spindle. Seconds matter when we're running quick parts, and this machine gives us those extra seconds to be more competitive when we're running small diameter material. The K16 comes with a 12-foot automatic bar loader. One piece of advice, really small diameter material will tend to spaghetti up on you and get jammed up. Make sure your bar loader's set correctly, make sure you have the right channels in it, make sure the rollers are set correctly so it'll auto load smoothly and you can keep it running all night, lights out. We like running lights out just as much as the next guy, and we do a lot of that here at Kremin Incorporated. But the one thing we don't like about this machine is there's no lights within the operator area. It's completely dark. There's a couple windows to try to get exterior lighting in, but it's not really effective. Especially when you're talking about tiny tools in a compact workspace, we really wish Citizens would have put some lights inside this machine. I really like the small compact space on the K16, the rapid movements, the ability to run small parts even faster than some of the larger machines. I like the 12-foot auto feed bar feeder. I wish it'd be a little easier to run really small diameter material because it can get spaghettied up. And I wish Citizens would have added a light inside the work cabinet. All in all, 4 out of 5 stars. K16 is a solid machine. Talk to your dealer if you're interested. Take care.